are going to revise the fourth chapter, that is sorting materials into groups. When we look around, we can see different types of objects. Okay, here you can see desk, chair, book, notebook, pencil, backpack, scissors, compass, pin, clips, many types of objects. Okay, so when we look around, we find ourselves surrounded by a number of objects. Okay, some of these objects are made from different types of materials. Some are made of same type of material. Desk and bench, that is made of same type of material. What about pen, dustbin, all these? It is made of plastics. Okay, so the things are made up of different types of
properties.
So we should know the properties of materials. Okay, the first one is appearance. Okay, in the appearance of the properties, we are going to group it. So there are lustrous and non-lustrous materials. Okay, all metals are lustrous. Here you can see gold. Gold is very lustrous. So all metals comes under lustrous. By the way, what is lustrous? Lustrous means shining appearance. And some materials are non-lustrous. Okay, so all metals are lustrous. Okay, gold, copper, aluminium, iron, all these are, sometimes these metals lose its lustrous quality. Okay, how? When they act upon moisture and air. When it exposed to moisture and air, this lustrous appearance will be fading. So only the freshly cut metals appear to have luster on them. Now the second point is hardness. Okay, metals can be classified on the basis of hardness. Some are very hard and some are very soft. Hard metal materials and soft materials. Sponge. If you touch the sponge, you can compress it. So it is very soft. What about the stone? Stone you can't compress. It is very hard. Okay. So on the basis of hardness, the materials can be grouped into hard and soft. Okay. Third one is soluble and insoluble. Okay, materials can be dissolved in water. Some materials dissolve in water and some do not dissolve in water. Sugar, salt, all these can be dissolved in water. What about sand, stone? All these do not dissolve in water. So, on the basis of solubility, we can group the materials into soluble and insoluble. Okay. See, soluble and insoluble. Soluble means the substance which dissolve in water. Okay, the substance which will not dissolve in water or liquid are called insoluble, that precipitate under the water. Okay, then the fourth one is object which float or sink in water. Floating or sinking. Okay, there are some insoluble objects or material which sink to the bottom of the surface when dissolving water, while some float on water. Okay, some materials float on water and some materials sink on water. Oil, dried leaves, all these float on water. What about sand, stone, all these that sink, rock, all these sink in water. Here you can find a wood cork that is floating on the water, other some metal like cords that sink in water. So some materials can float on water, some can sink in water. Next one is transparency. According to the transparency, the materials again grouped into transparent, translucent and opaque. So what is transparent, what is translucent and what is opaque? Okay. So let's see what is transparent object. Transparent means the material which allow the light to pass through it. So we can see the objects through that materials. So that is known as transparent. Here you can see glass, clear water, some certain types of plastics, all these are transparent. Okay, then what about translucent? Object which pass the light partially through it. So, through which the things can be seen partially. The materials through which the things can be seen partially. Such objects are known as translucent objects. Okay, examples, butter paper, frosted glass, all these are examples for translucent objects. Okay, next one, opaque. Opaque means the object which do not pass the light through it. So we are not able to see the object through that materials. Such materials are known as opaque. Such objects are known as opaque objects. Wood, stone, rock, all these are opaque objects. Clear? Yes. See here, opaque, translucent and transparent. Now let's see, why do we need to group the object? Why we should group the object? Why we should group the object? For a number of reasons. To keep everything in a systematic order and to convenience to store the materials and convenience to study the materials. So we should group in systematic order.
Okay. Hope the content is clear to you. Thank you for watching me.